Latoya Sanders. We have an awesome show for you again this week. But before we get into the show, I just want to take this time to really acknowledge life itself. Last Saturday, a family friend of ours, his son was killed in a tragic accident in the Dallas area. Well, he was actually killed in Oklahoma. And his death really put something on my heart. It really let me know that even as he was only 17 years old, even as a youngster, we really have to appreciate life itself. Each and every day that God blesses us with another day, we really need to take time and give God thanks for that. Yeah. No matter what situation we're going through, no matter how hard times get, no matter if we can't pay the bills, no matter if we don't have food on our table, no matter what it is, it's better than being dead. I want you guys to know that death itself, it's permanent. It's permanent. It's a permanent way to leave this world that we know today. As Christians and as believers, we know that that's not the end, but death itself, it's final and it's permanent. So as you're on this earth, I just really advise you, I just really recommend that you take every day and do everything you can. First of all, love God.
Yes.
No matter what's going on in your life, love God. Okay? He deserves it just because you're still here. But like I was saying, we have an awesome show for you today. I have a great guest, and she's from Malakoff, Texas. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
My name is Shalina Douglas, and how are you tonight?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm excited about you being here.
Thank you.
I really am.
So is that.
Okay. Shalina, she's not like some of the guests that I've had, you know, just really didn't have a Christian foundation or anything. She was born and raised in the church. Born and raised. Your mom's a missionary, is that right?
That's correct.
Tell us what happened. You turned 18, you grown, you can do what you want to do. What happened?
Yeah, basically, I kind of, as they say, you smelling yourself, and I thought that, and kind of hard-headed, felt that I was ready to get married, met this guy, and I just thought that I was so in love, and, you know, I was living in Dallas, and he wanted to go to Oakland, California, and that's where we left. And against my mother's wishes, of course.
What was your mom saying?
She, you know, mothers have that intuition.
Right.
They
that
know.
Dope.
And she knew that I did not need to go. She knew that that was not a good move for me.
But you loved him, huh?
So I thought.
You thought. Right.
And I left against her wishes. We had a taxi come to the house, and we
passed
a taxi.
I'm going to Oakland.
Yeah, funny. And wrote the book.
Tell us about that. Once you got to Oakland, what happened?
Well, everything was good. I mean, his family was there, his mom, his sister. And I thought that all was well. You know, this is a pretty good family, and so on and so on, but little did I know. As time went on, the longer I was there, I began to see changes in him, you know, different things occurring. I applied for a job at a Kelly Moore paint store, and I was in an interview with the manager. And he came, obviously we were in there too long, and he came and knocked on the door and asked, what were we doing and what was taking me so long? Was I in there having sex with the manager?
Oh my God.
And I mean, he was really insecure, very jealous. And while I was in the interview, he, you know, was walking around and looking, and he saw that there were males, a lot of males working at the paint store. And when we left, he told me, if you do get the job, you better not talk to nobody. You're not here to make friends, you're here to work. So I didn't say anything, but when we got home, you know, he basically told me that I wasn't gonna work there. And I was upset because I wanted a job, I wanted my own money, and he wasn't having it.
So he was controlling.
Very.
Very controlling. Very. So did that get worse? What happened?
Well, we got out the car, and of course I was trying to plead my case, and you know, I wanna work, and so on and so on. And he basically got upset because I was going against what he was saying.
Right.
So he came around the car and punched me in my face.
Was that his first time hitting you?
That wasn't the first time. I'll take that back. That was the first physical blow.
Right. So everything else was maybe shoving and pushing.
Exactly.
And okay.
Exactly.
So he hits you. How often does this occur after that? Does it start to happen more?
More often. After that point, and his mom and dad were standing outside, and nobody ever did anything. They never said anything. As a matter of fact, as time went on, he allowed his mother to hit me.
Oh, God. Honestly. So you were being physically and emotionally abused by the entire family.
Exactly.
And you stayed in it?
I stayed there. I always told myself, because my mom was a single parent.
Right.
And I'm getting emotional.
That's okay. Young people need to see that when we don't listen to our parents, there are consequences.
Yeah.
And usually, they're negative. I want you to remember while you're doing this interview that you're helping somebody. You're encouraging somebody. You're motivating somebody to do the right thing. So I want you to just be yourself.
Yeah. Wow.
It's okay. It's all about kingdom building. It's all about letting
yes.
people know what God
Thank
can
you, Lord.
And
Thank
will do for you.
Thank you.
Know, even if you make a mistake, it's all about letting people know that God will bring you out.
Yes.
He's a deliverer.
Yes.
He's a healer.
Yes.
He's a comforter. That's what it's all about. You know, it's people out there right now going through issues, battling with things. But this is an example.
That's right.
This is a woman that has been through and been where you are. She's a witness. This is her testimony.
Yes.
No matter what the devil has done, he cannot take away
That's
her
right.
testimony.
That's right.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's right.
So, You go through all this. It's terrible. It's rough. He's beating you. His mom is beating you.
Mm-hmm.
And your parents are thousands of miles
yeah.
away.
Yeah.
So do you stay in it? Do you get out? What do you do?
I stayed there for a little while. And we got into a huge fight one night. Because I didn't sing happy birthday. I wouldn't sing happy birthday to his mother because I knew she didn't like me. So I'm thinking, why should I sing happy birthday to her?
Right.
I mean, I'm thinking logically, this lady doesn't even like me. Why
am I gonna do this?
Yeah, so he didn't like that.
Because you did what he did, you wouldn't obey him.
Exactly.
Right.
And